It is the culminating match day in the local Philippine club football scene. And we're talking, of course, about the Copa Paulino Alcantara title decider between Kaya and Davao. But before that, we have one more title to settle in the PFF U19 Boys National Championship 2023 in the second division. And of course, we're talking about Kaya FC Iloilo, their U19 squad, and Palawan FA, the representative team, of course, of Luzon for this match. Mabuhay Pilipinas, and we welcome you here at the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium for the finale of your PFF U19 Boys National Championship, to be followed, of course, by the Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023 Championship match. Levi Verora on the call as we break down this match at hand again. Kaya FC Iloilo and Palawan FA. Let's take a look at the starting rosters for both teams. Let's go with Kaya FC Iloilo first. The head coach is Craig Livingston. And you talk about Kaya, you talk about players from their academy. This is one of the most successful grassroots programs and yung professional pathway, kumbaga, na inilalatag ng Kaya for these individuals. Kitang-kita naman, and you see some of the familiar names already. Nathan Bata, Julian Romero, who had a call-up doon sa senior squad, and then Sian Galsim. Some of these players already playing in the collegiate ranks for very prominent colleges and universities. And so, masusubukan ang Kaya. They are the Vismin group stage champion. They were undefeated going into this match. And we will see if, you know, on paper, sila yung limado, if it translates to the match which will kick off in just a short while. Dabako naman tayo sa Palawan FA, the starting 11 for this match. The longtime head coach is Coach Antonio Austria. Such a wonderful story when you talk about grassroots football. We'll talk about that in more detail as the match goes along. But here are the starters. The captain is also the goalkeeper. That is Zaki Ponce de Leon. We also have some players here. Ang maganda sa Palawan, most of the players coming from the city and the municipalities. They have 18 players lined up. 8 ang nanggaling sa municipalities and then 10 from the city center. But it's safe to say, all of them coming from Palawan, grassroots talagang yung pagiging local nila ang masusubukan dito. And it they might be overachieving already, yan ang kataga, at least from the leaders of Palawan FA. But here they are, they have one more match in front of them. Might as well shoot for the stars. We have more of the action when we return, the official march in as well as kickoff. So don't go away. Once again, the U19 Boys National Championship for the second division this year. It's Kaya FC Iloilo and Palawan FA. So don't go away. Such a beautiful sight for players of Palawan. They've made the trip, of course, from the island province all the way here to the Mecca of Philippine football. That is Rizal Memorial Football Stadium. Live po tayo, mga kaibigan, on the PFF Facebook and YouTube platforms. And there they are, Palawan FA in their yellow with the black shorts. Samantala sa kabila, Kaya FC Iloilo, their U19 squad, wearing black and white. Doon naman sa kanilang trunks. And then, of course, the familiar green, yellow, and red trim doon sa balikat. Kaya FC Iloilo versus Palawan FA. This is it, the national championship para po sa PFF U19 boys. One of the premier grassroots competitions na meron tayo sa ating bansa. Of course, the newly elected president, Mr. John Gutierrez, putting emphasis on how to develop further yung ating mga grassroots talents. And you're seeing, of course, just one of the manifestations from, of course, the previous administration as well, kung paano natin pinaiikting pa yung ating grassroots competitions with players like, of course, from Kaya and Palawan. This is Vismin versus Luzon. John Mike Basina is the referee for this match, assisted by 30 Saluria, Hussein Magusara. Fourth official is Chrismel Kayabyab. Referee assessor is Roberto Hernandez. And your match commissioner is Ms. Ira Ilan. In just a short while, we will kick off this match, which serves as a precursor to Kaya versus Davao later on in the Copa. But of course, for these players on the field right now, this is the centerpiece of their afternoon and the centerpiece of their entire calendar year as far as competitive football is concerned. Yan ang kagandahan ng ating local or ng ating domestic football scene here. You see the stars of tomorrow slugging it out today. Once again, magandang hapon po sa kanilang lahat. This glorious weather here inside Rizal Memorial Football Stadium in the capital city of Manila. In just a short while, we will bring you the action and a lot of storylines na mababanggit natin paunti-unti as the match goes along. But for now, this is what matters for these two clubs. Looks like it's going to be Kaya to kick us all off. And that is player number 22, Adrian Pesilier, who is also the forward in that 4-1-4-1 formation for Kaya. And here we go for all the marbles. This is the PFF Boys U19 National Championship for the 2nd Division. Glad to have you join us on this Saturday afternoon full of football action. And we are underway. Now for Kaya, again wearing black. They're playing from left to right as we speak. In contrast, Palawan FA, of course, in yellow. As Nathan Bata gets his first touch this afternoon. The kind of program, again, Kaya FC Iloilo in their academy has put up. There's no question. We spoke with Coach Craig Livingston kanina. He said they produce great players who go to college. And there's no question already with these youngsters on the screens. We have boys playing in UP. We have boys playing in LaSalle and PUP. Although at the moment they've been dispossessed but taken care of by Tortona. Trying to delay the counter-attack there was Palawan for a moment. Kaya, mabilis rin namang nakabalik itong Palawan. Palawan, of course, coached by Coach Antonio Austria, who has been the head coach since 1993. Imagine, 30 years, 3 decades of coaching experience. Although bola, ngayon ang Kaya, they send it forward. Almost losing control. Now they get it back. This is Benjamin Palacio. And retrieved by Romero. The ball will stay with Kaya, of course. Opening minutes of this match. Kaya FC, the Group B winner. They are the Vismin Group Stage champion, so to speak. They swept the opposition there, undefeated, versus Zambasulta, North Davao, and Agsurfa as well. They played three matches in Zamboanga, two matches in Dumaguete. And Coach Craig Livingston also saying na parang five away games for Kaya, who of course most of their players based in the academy here. Nevertheless, of course, Kaya never forgetting to just, you know, represent the roots and just maintain the links to local football. Romero wins it back with some resistance, but the flag is raised. Spot kick in a precarious position here for Kaya. See that on the replay. Romero wins it back and then naharangan yung kanyang potential path, and that is why the whistle was blown. This is Benjamin Palacio III. Token wall being presented here by Palawan just to bother the line of sight. Whistle's been given. Here is the lob. It bounces, but it's wide. The initial incursion for Kaya, courtesy of Lawrence Albert Tortona. Promising first few minutes here for Kaya, who again undefeated in the Vismin group stage. And if you're wondering what's in it for these squads, parehas na pong nakaangat sa Division 1 itong mga player na ito from Kaya and Palawan as Bata collects. So as far as promotion or relegation is concerned, wala na po. They're already promoted to Division 1 along with two other teams dahil apat na koponan po yung umangat. But again, this is to decide the national champion. It's Luzon versus Vismin. And it's for all the marbles. Sino ang tatanghaling kampyon for the entire archipelago? That's what's at stake this afternoon. Kaya, once again, they go to the middle. They try to thread it. They get it back inside the box. Zaki Ponce de Leon collects. 5 minutes in, and we already see the intensity picking up in this finale. Ang Palawan FA naman po, they had 5 points in their group. They managed to steal one against Cordillera FA, a 2-2 draw. And then Central Bicol, as well as the Olongapo Zampales FA. Yan yung mga nakalaban nila sa Luzon on their way to being on this stage. And it's such a privilege, of course, for the players here, mostly coming from Palawan, the municipalities, and then 10 coming from the city. In other words, lahat homegrown. And of course, you have a homegrown coach, Coach Antonio Austria, who has been in the business since 1993. We talk about Coach Antonio Austria. Ever since naka-graduate po ng college, ito si Coach Antonio Austria, eh, sumabak na sa larangan ng coaching. He is actually the grassroots development head ng Palawan FA, and has found his niche in terms of just what he wanted to do while also embracing the beautiful game. What a story it is. Samantala ngayon, it's still Kaya. First few minutes of this match, nasa kanila yung control ng bola. It looks like we will have the first corner set piece of the match. And it belongs to Kaya. Set pieces, of course. Kung makikita nyo sa inyong mga screens yung height differential, eh, Kaya ang nakalalamang dyan. Could be a header. It depends on the execution. And there it is, that one. Gets a touch from Adrian Pesilier. It's just off target. A busy start to this match for the defense of Palawan, to say the least. From distance, that just ricochets off a player from Kaya. Kaya playing a 4-1-4-1, so shades of Coach Yoshida here and the system that they're used to in the senior ranks. Ito namang Palawan in a 4-4-2, sometimes shifting to a 3-5-2, so just a lot of defensive holding doon sa gitna. 8 minutes in, 0-0 battle. And glad to have you join us. Pleasant afternoon to all. Once again, this is the PFF U19 Boys National Championship. Well, not much Kaya can do that time to make the chase. Ponce de Leon, the keeper for Palawan, wearing all blue, is also the team captain. It's a long one, but no connection made. But not the finest of touches as well for Kaya's defense. That is Sian Galsim. Ball just going to the skies for three consecutive touches. And then now finally ending up with Kaya. Weaving past the defense. Julian Paul Hanke, now they leave it to the left side. Chance, it's in! Opening goal, Kaya FC Iloilo. And it is Adrian Pesilier, the forward. No one else, of course. A fitting start here for Kaya FC Iloilo. And an excellent build-up play as they go up 1-0. A great setup for Kaya. The individual effort goes on design with Francisco, leaving it for Pesilier. That one took another touch. Three consecutive passes. This was Francisco. And then to the left wing. Ito yung assist pass, and then just all sorts of room for Pesilier to deliver that one home. Yan ang nagagawa ang depensa ng Palawan doon. Just a little bit too late on the recovery. And Kaya, another shot. This time it's been deflected. Great effort from Ponce de Leon, but you can just sense that the attacks here for Kaya, they are going to pour it on. Ten minutes into this match. And referee John Mike Basinang looks like may itinapon lang na debris. Of course, for the safety of our players. Good delivery as well. Tapped away. It looks like that one just rolls through. They double their lead, Kaya FC Iloilo, in just a matter of a few minutes. It's Gail Guerrero, the tallest man on the field. Yan yung sinasabi natin, the height advantage for those corner set pieces. The connection made there. Palacio to Guerrero. Promising start here for Kaya FC Iloilo. You see the replay a couple of times there. Just the positioning of Guerrero. It was good that he stayed onside. Again, it's just that height disparity between Kaya and Palawan as that ball goes out. And just like that, the commanding 2-0 cushion for Kaya. Again, we just talk about their campaign in the Vismin group stage. They went undefeated dun sa kanilang mga laban last November. And Palawan already knowing that it's a difficult challenge against the much favored, at least on paper, Kaya FC Iloilo. And they're showing just why in the first dozen minutes of action here. Just getting that ball to the attacking third is Kaya. Several occasions in the first 13 minutes of this match. And now Palawan. A rare chance for them. Left flank and a foul on Kaya. It looks like we also have a yellow card. I think we saw that yellow being raised. Si Ian Galsim at fault. Tingnan natin kung ano nangyari dito. It was Pineda. Ayun, hinatak. I don't think it was Galsim, but one player from Kaya has been booked. Jarrell Pineda is going to deliver this spot kick from just outside of the box doon sa bandang kaliwa. Pagkakataon para sa Palawan FA to try and build something here in the first half. Nakadalawa na ang Kaya. Let's see if makabawi sila in the early moments of the first half. Guerrero again using that size advantage to his favor. Although Palawan able to control. Pineda tried to lob that one. But it's going to be a corner for Palawan. Ball bounces off a Kaya body. So an inspiring spell here for Palawan in the last 2 minutes or so. Good elevation on that ball as well. It's a scramble inside the box. Pero pumito ang ating referee. Lots of pushing and shoving. It's going to be a foul on Palawan. And nevertheless, again, great effort on the part of the Luzon representative. Here's that lob once again. Yun lang, yung mga sumasampa sa likuran ng depensa. That's something that our referees will always call. 15 minutes into the first half. Once again, pleasant afternoon to all. This is the PFF U19 Boys National Championship for the 2nd Division. Deep into the right flank. Kaya able to control. They send it to the middle. Someone's down. That was Palacio, but no call. And contact on the high boot, perhaps. Foul on Kaya. If you are just joining us, Adrian Pesillier in the 9th minute, followed by a header from Gail Guerrero in the 11th minute. 2 minutes separating the two conversions from Kaya. And that is why it is now 2-0 on your scoreboards as we speak. Mabuhay Pilipinas, live po tayo from the Philippine Football Federation Facebook and YouTube platforms. Here's a cross for Palawan. And nakikita natin, it's Pineda doon sa kaliwang, on the left wing. We can say it's a sheer dominance for Kaya so far, as expected. Even Palawan FA expected this kind of level from Kaya. But that's why you play these matches, just to see what else needs to be done, what has to be improved. Some pressure here from Kaya as they try to win possession back. They do, and look how quickly they're able to release from the back and now to the middle. This is Romero, threads that needle beautifully for the target man. Janke, oh, dummy play, and now Romero again. They're just trying to confuse Palawan at the moment. And now they just try to settle. Bata will go outside of the area. And that's the luxury that they can afford, being up 2-0 at the moment. To mga bata ni Coach Craig Livingston. And gaya ng nabanggit ni Coach Craig, Kaya, of course, still just maintaining that link to the community. They have some players here from GK, from Gawad Kalinga, from Mandaluyong. And most of the players here have been part of the academy for 6 years, 7 years, and 8 years. So makikita mo yung pathway na ibinibigay ng Kaya just in terms of that. Here's the cutback on the rebound. It is high and out. Too much mustard on that shot. As we see Hanke once again, and then another cutback. Just too high for Benjamin Palacio. Could have had his conversion. He was the one who assisted the header of Gael Guerrero in the 11th minute. Scramble in the middle. But that ball has not been in Palawan's attacking third that much. Once again, targeting Pineda. But taken care of nitong Kaya backline. You have Gabriel Andre Bautista. You have Gael Guerrero, the goal scorer. Sian Galsim and Julian Romero. That's basically the back four for Kaya. And then in the middle is Lawrence Albert Tortona, acting as sort of a holding midfield for the boys. And then just lots of offensive options for them as well. Everyone almost just getting involved doon sa kanilang atake, talking about Kaya. But it's a long afternoon for Palawan. 70 minutes and change para sa kanila to try and convert. Clearance offered by Palawan. Romero. And you can also sense right now na papakiramdaman natin that Kaya, it's not to say that they're relaxing, but of course they're more patient and deliberate now with how to execute the passing and just stringing together a sequence that may lead to another shot attempt. Oh, good effort that time from, I believe that was RJ Argueles as he gets tagged. Shoulder to shoulder rule being utilized by Argueles to win the ball back for Palawan. Now the challenge here really for Palawan, as we see this long one, and it just goes straight to Bata, and whistle also. So no problem there for Nathan Bata. Again, the challenge here for Palawan is really just to build from the back, because there's all sorts of pressure from Kaya. You have all areas covered, as we see. 20 minutes approaching the halfway point of the first half. Maganda sa panahon ngayon, it's not too hot, hindi tirik yung araw for these young gentlemen, of course. And that ball goes straight to Nathan Bata, who of course hasn't been involved that much so far sa ating laban. That's owing to the fact that Kaya has kept the ball to their side. Oh, there's that excellent 1-2 once again. Palacio to Hanke. And they earn a corner. Wala nang magagawa si Cabaylo. Hindi ibigay ang second corner para sa Kaya. That sliding challenge. And the first corner for Kaya from this side. In-swinger, perhaps. Jeffy Tinge, that one takes a deflection from Ponce de Leon. Looks like it just bounces off the crossbar. Contact made by Ponce de Leon. Goal kick for Palawan. It's the start that people expected from Kaya. 2-0 early on in this match. Gaya ng nabanggit natin for Palawan, they have more than 70 minutes to try and score two, but it should start, of course, by building some favorable sequences. Here's one. Almost won that ball. Kaya will get this out of trouble. Galsim to the opposite side. More pressure here from Palawan. Have more yellow shirts up front. And it pays off. Bola babalik sa Palawan for now. For those of you just joining us, Palawan wearing yellow with their black shorts. Kaya in black with white trunks. Good activity from Francisco. They send it out immediately. It's again intended for Julian Paul Hanke, who just displays that individual skill. Back to Francisco. He was taken down. No contact really to merit a foul. Bola mawawala and it will proceed with this goal kick once again. You can see that Palawan, they're really not connected right now. Just one long ball, one pass to get it out of the back, but there are no recipients at the moment. That's what keeps the pressure of playing against one of the most established youth squads in the country, of course. And again, this is Kaya. Both of them already promoted to Division 1. Apat na katanan ang kumangat from Division 2 up to Division 1. Kasama na ang Kaya at Palawan doon. They're joined by two more among the top finishers, the top four finishers. Meanwhile, another sequence. They've been going to that since a few minutes ago. The cutback, this time met by Palawan. Cortona gives it to Romero once again. Kaya taking their time. It's really just a matter of textbook execution now for them. They're up 2-0. Not much pressure from that point of view. 25 minutes into this match. Again, 9th minute conversion from Adrian Pasillier. 11th minute conversion from Gail Guerrero. That's the score line that we have so far. 25 minutes into this match. Mayapo, of course, it's going to be Kaya FC Iloilo and Davao Aguilas UMAC FC. That is for the Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023 title. Sino ang magwawagi ng ating year-ending cup for the local or the domestic club football scene here in the Philippines? There's that 1-2 once again, but the flag is up. First offside call of the afternoon. Kaya. As looks like we have a hydration break here. And malino naman from that angle. Jeffy Tinge already ahead of the pack for Kaya FC. Natawagan ng offside. Now we have a hydration break here, of course. Have to stay hydrated, even kayo po na nanonood on your screens right now. Let's make it a habit to drink liquids and not get caught in the heat of Metro Manila. Alam ko pa parating na ang Pasko, but at this time of the day, it's still hot. It can still get scorching hot. And we kicked off at 3:30 in the afternoon. That means 2:30 pa lang ay nagwa-warm up na itong mga koponan na ito on the outer or on the field. And we all know 2 p.m. usually that's the hottest time of the day. We'll return to the action soon. And just a refresher once again, Adrian Pasillier, the forward, making it 1-0 for Kaya in the 9th minute. And then 2 minutes after, off a corner kick, it was Benjamin Palacio III assisting to Gail Guerrero, whose head made contact with the ball and into the back of the net. Second goal for Kaya, courtesy of Guerrero, 11th minute. And from there, it's been 2-0 ever since. You can also see the grandstand area of the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium slowly filling up. We have, of course, Davao and Kaya kicking off at 7 in the evening. That is for the Copa title. But for now, again, serving as the appetizer, as a precursor, is the PFF U19 Boys National Championship. Kaya FC Iloilo, the Vismin representative, they swept Group B to become the Vismin Group Stage Champion. Palawan FA, the Luzon representative, the Group A winners, they are the Luzon Group Stage Champions. So it's champion versus champion, but of course there can only be one national champion to rule the entire archipelago. Great display of skill. Here's the cutback and choosing the far post, but it just goes wide. Adrian Pesillier easily could have been a brace. Easily could have been 3-0. Great decision making on the part of Pesillier. Just couldn't get the proper cut on that ball. As we will look at Ponce de Leon, he was on the near post. It's malapit siya doon. Nakita agad ni Pesillier niya is just a couple of inches to the right. So it stays at 2-0. It's been pretty much a one-sided showdown so far, with Kaya just getting that ball to their attacking half. Palawan not much so far that they've offered in terms of just disrupting Kaya's defense. It's been a defensive approach for them, with Kaya dominating control of the ball in the first 29 minutes, approaching the half-hour mark of this match. Able to control Tingue, but not enough space to try and round that ball back. Nevertheless, he and Benjamin Palacio acknowledge. Ang maganda doon for Kaya is that a last touch on the defender of Palawan. And so even if Jeffy Tingue run out of space, it's going to be a corner rewarded for Kaya. They've scored one from the corner set piece. It's going to be an in-swinger here. Pero napalayo, and Palawan able to meet that ball. Wins it back. And now they send it to the middle. Vendorillo could be a chance. But Nathan Bata, of course, not want to be outdone here. And he just knows when to go out of the goal area. Anticipating that ball, Nathan Bata preventing any sort of attack or attempt here for Palawan. Palawan, of course, Reagan Gabinete, one of their two forwards doon sa kanilang 4-4-2 formation. Sila yung nasa dulo, doon sa unahan. Mandawe getting a touch. Lester J. Mandawe gives it to back to Gabinete rather. Palawan keeping that ball, and now a solo effort from the middle. To the left flank once again. This is Pineda. But on the lob. Using the left foot. There's a good look at player number 17, Jarrell Pineda, who plays as a winger. Galsim. Again, just by now we will be used to Kaya, to seeing Kaya just playing with more patience, knowing that they are up 2-0. Not much pressure either from Palawan at this moment from the back. Galsim Romero, oh, excellent 1-2. What a sequence. Could this be another? Trying to make that connection for Pesillier, but good effort to intercept. Zaki Ponce de Leon, the busier between the two keepers, without question. Ball is won back. Venturillo sends it forward for Pineda, but too much strength on that touch. It goes out. And ito yung sinasabi natin, Palawan, of course, not being able to win that many balls, that many, just the fair share of possession here. They have to just take care of that ball a little better. This looks like someone's been tagged for a foul. Kaya takes that quickly. Pero mabilis rin namang nakapag-set up itong Palawan. Oh, that ball just left for Kaya. Could be a chance. They have the numbers. And two players going off balance. Not enough to merit a penalty, at least from our vantage point. That's a correct non-call. Nevertheless, Kaya still has it inside the box. But this one is a rocket and it goes out. So Jeffy Tinge. Interesting sequence there for Kaya inside of the 34th minute. It's getting that ball to where they want to. At the end of the day, it's just the finishing for them. This one headed back is gathered by Pata. He sends it back out. Pagandaan dito sa Kaya, mabilis yung pag-release ng bola, Romero. Again, not much effort as well from Palawan in terms of pressuring. Medyo mababa yung kanilang depensa. And that ball transitions to them. Solo effort here, not enough numbers for Palawan. That ball short-lived. Para dito kay Gabinete. Palawan sends it out. Venturillo just trying to delay the attack here for Kaya. Fifth minute, 10 more minutes before the conclusion of the first half. Where Kaya has gone on to go up 2-0. And another chance here. And this one just fails to trickle in. From the left side, shot from inside the box. Another shot that goes just wide. For Kaya, someone is down. Looks like that's Benjamin Palacio. It's not a penalty, of course. Good to see him back up on his feet. ...36 minutes and counting here, Palawan will have to work on their offense as we go along. If that, of course, if they want to score and get back here. Venturillo lobs this one, intended for Gabinete, but Kaya's defense has already established. And Bata picks it up. You can also sense that perhaps Palawan is conserving their energy for the second half because they have less subs here compared to Kaya. Solo effort from Julian Romero. Threads that needle again. Just the vision of this man into the box. Oh, and another volley is out. The second consecutive instance for number 68, Tinge. We'll see that. That's why he's frustrated. That's already the second attempt for him. Good turn for Palawan. But even better defense for Kaya. Just not giving anything here for Palawan. That's how you respect your opponent, precisely. Guerrero sends it back for Galsim. They form their triangle here, and now they make it a diamond with Palacio. Kaya again, just releasing that ball with relative ease. And the flag is up once again. Offside call number two for Kaya. They tried the long one intended for Pineda. It does not get the proper angle to get that ball to him. Bata collects. And, of course, by now we know that that's the expected sequence for Kaya. Sharing that ball. An obvious call to make. Gaminede with the contact against Tortona. Kaya puts it back into play. Ang maganda rin ginagawa ng Kaya rito is just the passing in between the spaces, in between the players, and that's how you really advance that ball to begin with. Either you go through the defense, over the defense like this long ball. There are many approaches to it. Kaya doing a great job doing all. To the box. Naiwan pang bahagya, but it's back with Kaya in the middle. Pesilier, ibabalik muna sa kanan, this time Romero. Tries to get fancy with it, but good defense from one of the fullbacks here for Palawan. That was John Benedict Cabaylo. Approaching the 40th minute mark of this match, which is again the final of your PFF U19 boys. Deep into the box. The shot is deflected by Ponce de Leon. And that is attempt number three for Jeffy Tingue. Well, he had someone to his right. Adrian Pesilier, that is. Decides to take it. Ponce de Leon, even if he saved that one, it's going to be a corner for Kaya. And that's why Ponce de Leon, the captain for Palawan, a bit frustrated as well. Dahil yung mga kasama niya, yung mga kakampi niya, especially the defense, they will have to go back better than that and just recover on the play. It's another high looping delivery. Still inside the box, Guerrero, and this one collected easily this time by Ponce de Leon. He tried to go direct to Gabinete, but too many black shirts bothering Guerrero. Out of trouble to the left for Bautista. Kaya once again. They weave that ball to the middle against three. Oh, that's too much. Azucena this time. And again, they're just targeting Pineda at this point. Nothing materializing for Palawan at this juncture. 40 minutes have gone by. And just to give an update again, it's Kaya 2 and Palawan 0. Two goals. One from Adrian Pesilier in the 9th minute, and then another from Gael Guerrero in the 11th. Inside of the 42nd minute, about 3 more minutes plus added. We have not really seen a lot of significant stoppages throughout the first half. Good turn. Ooh, but could be a missed touch. However, but Kaya has to time this well. Oh, good patience from Kaya, because kung minadali nila yun, it would have been an offside call. Instead, they win a few meters forward, and then they have a chance to send this in. Romero. Bibigay muna kay Julian Paul. That is number 18. Yanke, of course. To the middle. Tortona goes to his left. This is Palacio. One-on-one against Mandawi. And Palawan gets in the path. Good effort. Good turn as well. This is Pineda, who will try to take the matter into his own. Not enough numbers for Palawan. Pineda will credit the shot as Bata commits. But not enough power for Pineda to finish. Ponce de Leon, someone's chasing that ball, able to release it. Well, at the very least, nakikita natin ang kagandahan rito sa Palawan is they're slowly just playing to Kaya's level, as manifested in those passes and a foul, of course, for Kaya. Hindi na nahihirapan ang Palawan dito para dalhin yung bola from the back into the midfield and see if something happens. Good individual effort from Jamil as well to just bring that ball a little closer to Palawan's attacking half. This is going to be a long one, met by Kaya. And now it's going to be a counter for Kaya as they transition to their front. And here's the shot, poked away on the rebound, still saved. Back-to-back stoppages by Ponce de Leon. On two more shots by Kaya, as it is still 2-0. We'll see that once again. Kaya, they have the numbers. Julian Paul Hanke deflected, and then the header on the rebound. Oh, it was offside nevertheless. It was already offside. But of course, Ponce de Leon just playing to the whistle. I have to give credit to the guy, just not stopping until he hears that whistle. A shot from distance. And Palawan again, just all sorts of discombobulated here. Nangangapapa ng bahagya itong Palawan. Just the feeling out process here. It's a different field. It's a different environment. They're up against one of the strongest youth teams. But again, it's learning experience for them. It's one of those matches that you play just to gauge saan pa kulang, saan pa kailangan paigtingin at pagbutihin. And if you have been listening to our newly elected PFF president, President John Gutierrez, yun yung gusto niyang i-address, just the access to the training, to the pathway to be provided to our grassroots players so that they can be world-class, so that they can be as competitive as those who are in the capital, who are overseas. It's going to be an interesting next 4 years in the PFF cycle for that. Meanwhile, 2 minutes of added time ang inilagay rito. Our fourth official, once again, Chris Melcayabyab. Here's the lob. And now a transition, Palawan. They don't have the numbers, but Pineda, tinitimpla lang, of course, saan ilalagay yung bola. So Pineda can make his run, but you can sense the frustration from the man right now. As it has been, of course, a fruitless first half for Palawan, but nevertheless they have 45 more minutes after the break when we return to try and overcome this. Overall, the effort by Palawan to just keep the scoreline as it is, 2-0, and just give themselves a chance, eh mabuti na yung 2-0 kaysa 3-0 or 4-0 entering the other side of the break. Final few seconds here for Kaya. Dadagdagan pa ba? Looks like Palawan is content to bring this deficit with them to the halftime break. Lots of football to be played still. Kaya not yet out of the woods. They do have the upper hand. It's going to be an interesting second half for both sides. This is the PFF U19 Boys National Championship Second Division. Glad to have you join us once again on this afternoon. Mamaya maya po, it's Kaya FC Iloilo, their seniors team, going up against Davao Aguilas UMAC. One more chance perhaps, but getting in the way. And on the rebound, deflected once again. Ponce de Leon will not be broken, at least in that sequence. And that is the halftime whistle. Palawan FA, at the very least, making sure that there's still that sliver of hope in the second half. But nevertheless, for Kaya FC Iloilo, the damage has been done. It is 2-0 for the boys from Vismin, courtesy of Adrian Pesillier and Gail Guerrero. A 2-0 cushion that could ultimately be enough, but we will find out in the next 45 minutes. For now, it is the halftime break. Magbabalik po kami once again. This is your PFF U19 Boys National Championship, 2nd Division.
David versus, you're David, right? Daniel, sorry. Daniel and? All right, Daniel and Gal, let's do this, okay? Also, you're gonna do it at the same time. It's another ball, all right? 1 minute, Gal. You count your juggle, how many you can juggle in 1 minute. Ready, in 5, 4, 3, 2, go! 4, 5. Okay, who will lose it first? Oops, oops. All right, keep going. Ooh. 11 seconds. All right, Gap wins. All right. Okay, stay there, Daniel. We're gonna have next one. Okay, Gap and what's your name? Asai. Aljun. Okay, Asai versus Aljun. Ready? Come on, because winner, winner, we're gonna play the game. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Ready? Oh, not yet. Ready? Wait for the goal. Ready and go. Oops! Ah, we got Aljun versus Gap. Okay, who between you two will win the official ball signed by the Astros? Okay, let's give them a cheer! Woo! Yes! Ready? 1, 2, 3, go! Keep going. They have really good juggling skills. Almost there. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's give a round of applause to these two. And because we have to, the one can choose either the side Astro balls, or you can choose an official studs with the size of your choice. Okay, who wants studs? We got size 4, 6, and 5 or 7. Or the official Astro ball, okay? Who wants the two? Which one is? All right, Savannah's. All right, thank you so much. Let's give them a round of applause. But let us have a picture first. All right, okay. This one is a quick trivia, okay? Anyone can answer, all right? All right, have a picture. Okay, who can give me this one? This is a question, all right? For this one's trivia, if you are tuning up to the U19 journey for 2 years, are the champions last year, right? You know the champions of U19 Division 2? Luzon and Visayas Mindanao Division 2 winners. Oh, you don't know. Okay, we got two. You can choose either a shirt, a stud with the size of your choice, and a ball. All right, let's do this. Who can give me the Luzon Division 2 winner of U19? Last year, and this knee. Okay, I'll give you a clue. Okay, it is one of the clubs here. Okay, let's try. Who do you think is the winner? The champion last year? Luzon?
Stallion Laguna FC.
Laguna FC. All right, which one do you like? Okay, give me the Visayas Mindanao. It is an RFA, situated in Mindanao. All right, that's a clue already, yeah? Okay, who? Anyone? Yes. Okay, spell it out. What Timorga means? Oh, no. No one. Who knows what Simorfa is? Coming here? Come here, come up here. Hurry up, run up here. Come on, we're gonna help you. All right, come on, come here. Okay. Come up here. All right, each team, all right? Three members. Si Morfa.
Amigin, Misamis. Misamis, Football Association.
Okay, let's get have some help here. Alright, good job you two. Because you help each other pick your alright. See, Merfa is the winner. Now, who do you think is the winner for this year? Alright, we're going to tune in for that one, okay? Alright? Alright, so just be ready after game. We're gonna have the football tic-tac-toe. Okay, anyone who wants to be on that game, create three members for each team. Okay, we're gonna play here. Alright, are we good? Okay, can once again we have a cheer here at the Rizal Memorial Stadium for U19 Boys National Championship? Let's give it up for everyone here. Let's cheer and cheer. One, two, three.
And we are back here inside the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium as we approach the second half of Kaya FC Iloilo in Palawan FA, with Kaya currently on top 2-0. This is again for the national championship in your PFF Under-19 boys for 2023. This is the second division, and if you are wondering what's at stake, it's really just the prestige of being crowned national champion. Both of these clubs will automatically advance to the first division starting in next year's competition. We actually have four teams who advanced to the top division of the U19. And that's something similar to what Stallion did a few years ago. Let's take a look at the highlights just to give us an idea of where things stand at the moment. It was all Kaya right from the get-go, and this was the opening goal courtesy of Adrian Pesilier, 9th minute, and you saw how brilliant that sequence was. One pass right there, second pass, the running effort by Jeffrey Tinge to set up ito pong si Adrian Pesilier. Not long after, just 2 minutes after, ito namang si Benjamin Palacio III setting up on this corner set piece. That is Gail Guerrero, whose header just trickles inside and to the back of the net. One more look at it. 2-0 for Kaya at this point, 11 minutes of action. And as things just continued, it was all Kaya from their side of things. Makikita natin yan sa statistics later on. And then there are just some few moments for Kaya, or rather for Palawan, where they got that ball to their side. Mostly one-sided approach. Here's another shot from Tinge this time, who wanted to join the list of goal scorers. He had 3, in fact. Here's another one of them, 2-1. Shoots it with Pesilier on his right. And then Pineda, one of the few tries for Palawan. And this is the live action now. We have the statistics shown to you when we can. But right now, it is Kaya, again, protecting that 2-0 cushion. You can argue that it could have been a lot more for them. And for Palawan, 45 minutes to try and challenge the heavyweights of their youth division. Once again, pleasant afternoon to everyone. Mabuhay Pilipinas, Levi Verora on the call. Live po tayo from the Philippine Football Federation YouTube and Facebook platforms. One match to decide who becomes the national champion for the second division in your U19 boys category of the PFF National Championship. Again, one of the advocacies of the PFF is to really just raise the bar of grassroots football, and competitions like these are really a manifestation of that long-term goal for the national governing body in the sport of football here in the country. No changes, I believe, for Kaya. Palawan, mayroong isa. We will check with the officials later on. Great touch passing here, but it's not a problem for Ponce de Leon. Zaki Ponce de Leon, the goalkeeper for Palawan, of course, had a busy afternoon. Busy first half, of course, for him. Had to deflect several shots from Kaya just to prevent an even worse score line as someone gets dispossessed. Well, Kaya, if you have a heat map of this match, a lot of the sequences for Kaya just unfolding from the left side, sometimes in the middle, also from the right with Romero and Julian Paul Hanke. Pretty much all over the place here, talking about Kaya. And again, almost a one-sided affair. In the first half, 85% possession to Kaya, 15 for Palawan, 13 shots for Kaya, 5 on target, only 3 shots for Palawan, mostly coming from distance, only 1 on target, and that's, of course, from Jaril Pineda. Kaya FC in black with their white shorts, Palawan FA in yellow with black shorts, and Kaya now playing from right to left here earlier, or in the early stages of the second half. Here's Guerrero, one of the goal scorers. Gabriel Andre Bautista, one of the defenders. They put it back for Nathan Bata. And like what we said, perhaps itong Palawan just conserving some of that energy for the second half. They might just go on to press and try to steal one. Try to take one back here. Palacio. Bautista. Kaya taking their time, trying to get this out of the back. They go direct, but it is met by one of the players. Palawan on the offensive. They have some numbers here in the middle. And the shot, Gabinete, makes Nathan Bata commit, and it is saved. The left-footed strike coming from Reagan Gabinete. If you look at the formation here for Palawan, si Gabinete at si Pineda yung dalawang nasa unahan as the wingers, winger forwards, if you might say, 4-4-2 for Coach Antonio Austria. Sa kabila naman, Craig Livingston with a 4-1-4-1. Just lots of offensive options for Kaya. Kaya FC, the Luzon group stage champions. Now check that, the Vismin group stage champions. And here they are once again. Numbers here for Kaya. They go deep into the box. And that's it, a connection for goal number 3. Oh, check that. The flag was raised. Looks like an offside call. See if we can get a good look at the sequence. And that's why short-lived yung celebration ni Adrian Pesilier. No brace at the moment. Stays 2-0 for Kaya. But definitely after someone got deep into the flank, into one of the flanks for Kaya. And now back to live action. This time it's Francisco. And this one's in. No doubt about it. Jed Matthew Francisco from distance. And that is goal number 3 for Kaya. Well, this time it's official. They can celebrate that sequence. Jed Matthew Francisco is cleaning up the mess here for Kaya. We'll see a good look at that once again. But without question, it is now 3-0 for Kaya as they try to move closer to that national title. One of the players once again getting, it's a fumble actually for Pesilier, but somehow napaganda pa, as they say, as it turns into this shot by Francisco. It's pretty obvious na itong Kaya, they're just actively going to Pesilier, but everyone else has to be ready. And that's exactly what happened doon sa pagkakataon na yon. Jed Matthew Francisco just staying at the right place at the right moment. Nabiyayaan ng isang napakagandang tira without much resistance from Palawan. And it is now 3-0 for them as this is going to be an obvious foul. See on your screens, Venturillo. That is Kurt Venturillo, number 30. Nakausap natin si Coach Antonio Austria, the longtime head coach of Palawan FA in the youth level. Also the grassroots development coach or head ng Palawan FA. And nakwento nga niya, most of the players from Palawan, hiwa-hiwalay na eskwelahan. They have Palawan State University, Palawan National High School, Bethel International, and then West Philippine University. So paiba-iba. And it posed a challenge for Palawan para sa kanilang mga practice sessions dahil nga kinakailangan nilang magkita-kita to be in one common stadium or practice facility. Yung ilan lang sa mga naging pagsubok ng Palawan. And it's also been acknowledged by the team that Kaya really is a strong program, talented squad. And then just the logistical problems or challenges for Palawan that made it difficult for them to train consistently. But nevertheless, here they are as the Luzon group stage champions. They had 5 points in their group. They had a draw against Cordillera, 2-2. They also had favorable results against Central Bicol and the Olongapo Zambales FA. And that's why they are the Luzon representative. Meanwhile, Kaya, this shot takes a bounce and retrieved by Palawan once again. But no numbers here as they continue to target Gabinete. Enough effort for Galzim. Oh! Not the proper way to take it out para kay Nathan Bata. And now they send it back to him. Fortunate instance for Bata as he does not concede anything here. Could have been a precarious moment for Kaya. One of the very few mistakes they could have committed in this match. 55 minutes in. As Gabinete causes Francisco to go down. At siya naman ang natawagan. 3-0 once again for Kaya FC Iloilo and their under 19 squad. Para naman dito sa Kaya, of course, Coach Craig Livingston acknowledging the fact that they have a good pathway program for players in the youth level. They produce great players who go to different colleges. And ito nga lang, if you look at the roster of Kaya, eh, may mga familiar na pangalan na dyan. Some playing in UP, some from La Salle, and also Polytechnic University of the Philippines. Hopefully, once they're done with their collegiate activities, they have the chance to go back to Kaya and play for their club. And now Pineda, here's a shot. Good recovery from Kaya. A lot of black shirts being able to establish. And finally gets that ball out of trouble. Great effort once again from Pineda as this one is a through ball, but too much power on that one. As Jeffy Tinge unable to attend. Pero makikita natin Kaya most, if not all, of their attacks going forward. Eh, yan yung pinapakita nila, just that sound passing. Whether it's a through ball or a dummy play, a 1-2, they get that ball where they want to get it, and they do so in extraordinary fashion. And that's how you do your grassroots program, right? It's showing in this championship match for Kaya FC as they have the driver's seat, 3-0 advantage right now. And here's one of those again. Pesilier trying to win it back, but a great effort as well from Palawan to prevent that touch. Francisco. Deep down to the right flank. But not enough real estate for Kaya. Now we also had the chance to see one of the statements made by the Secretary General of the Palawan Football Association. That is, of course, Madam Princess Aura Lee Joya, who's saying that the presence of the Palawan team here in the national championship signifies the growing football scene in Palawan and also the dedication of the local players and coaches. Shouts to Guyito Hagedorn for supplying us with that information. We just saw it at the Philippine Football Hub. And it's pretty obvious that it's only the beginning for Palawan football and that they are capable of competing at the highest level in the country. That's according, again, to the Secretary General of Palawan FA, which is Madam Princess Aura Lee Joya. I'm glad to have you join us kung nakatutok po sila sa ating live stream. Once again, coming to you live from the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium in the capital city of Manila as we have another foul called here. Levi Verora on the call. This is the PFF U19 Boys National Championship. Second division being contested by Kaya and Palawan. Approaching the half-hour mark of this contest, and Kaya now with a more sizable 3-0 cushion. Coach Antonio Austria also mentioning that they're happy to be here. If they win the match, then that's a big bonus for them. But it's really just a matter of showing what they're capable of. And it's just the start of what else is to come for Palawan if of course they get their hands on top-notch training and just the resources to build a formidable squad in the national level. Gabinete once again. That one takes a deflection of Tortona. No changes so far for Kaya. Pero nakikita natin, well, you don't see it on your screens, but paunti-unti may mga players na yung Kaya from the substitutes that are warming up on the sides. Guerrero to the other fullback. That is Bautista. Send it forward once again. The connection here between Bautista and Tinge. Someone gets in the way. Good effort that time by Mandawe. Lester J. Mandawe intercepts the ball once again. What Kaya has been doing really well here is that they're really just getting that ball in between the spaces, in between those defenders. And that's how you advance and win meters in football. Here's that 1-2 again. Great play. cleared initially by Palawan and now inside. But Pesillier is dispossessed. Again, credit the defense of Palawan. It's been better than it was to start this match. And now they transition into a potential counter here. As it's going to be an impending corner for Palawan, but first looks like someone. John Benedict Cabaylo is going to be replaced by Johan Von Dumaran. Well, John Benedict Cabaylo is listed as a defender. Ito namang si Johan Von Dumaran is a forward. So you might say offense for defense ang ginawa na substitution rito ng Palawan. It's trying to be more offensive-minded and have more variety in terms of the attacks. Well, nangangailangan sila ng mga goal rito if they want to push this match into added time or extra time. Rising to the occasion, Mandawi, but does not get the touch. Possession recycled by Palawan, but not for long. As Romero directs traffic once again. Kaya this time. Trying to transition into their own counter. Hanke tries to leave it for Romero. Nevertheless, there is another shot from distance. Benjamin Palacio. A rocket of a shot and it goes in. Garbage to goal there for Kaya FC Iloilo. Well, just when we thought it was going to be a ball served to Romero, well, it's Benjamin Palacio III who does it. What a fantastic strike for Kaya FC Iloilo as they push the lead to 4-0. Take a good look at that. Might as well could have been a dummy play, but what a shot from distance for Palacio. An absolute screamer here. And the crowd getting involved. As it is now 4-0 for Kaya FC Iloilo in the 64th. Could be the early so-called dagger for Kaya as they continue to pounce on the hapless Palawan FA, who are doing their very best, but the quality, of course, of Kaya is just there. They try to go direct once again to Pineda, but it's been handled well by the defense of Kaya. Ball goes out. It looks like we have three substitutions for Kaya FC Iloilo. We have Kian Will Pampolina, player number 78. We also have player number 23, Marco Lorenzo Perez. And Ibrahim Tarin, player number 15. So three substitutions for Kaya. It's trying to put some fresh legs, of course, sa ating laro. Well, 4-0 now for Kaya FC Iloilo. They can afford to mix it up a little bit here. So Palacio will take a breather as well. Marco Perez has come on in. Three changes for Kaya after that conversion by Benjamin Palacio III, which got us all excited. Just a commanding lead for Benjamin Palacio, or for Kaya, of course. It could be goal number 5, but good effort by Ponce de Leon. And Mandawi does the rest to control that ball. Kaya FC Iloilo, however, wins it back. The sequence is not done yet. And here's a shot. But it goes out wide to the left. Although it took a deflection from Palawan, it's going to be corner number 6 for Kaya. They've earned more of those corner set pieces of being the team that attacks, that has attacked more. Could have been a missed touch. Masyadong mababa on the delivery. Controlled eventually by Palawan. Bagano threads that needle, but obviously a player from Palawan too ahead of the pack. An offside call here. Bata to Guerrero. Back to Bata. Nathan Bata, yet to concede the goal, has done a relatively quiet performance here for Bata. Well, it's not that they've needed him that much. More pressure for Palawan. Advancing forward, the yellow shirts. Kaya releasing easily once again. That's been a trend in this match. And now they thread the needle. They have the numbers here. But that ball left for Ponce de Leon, who wisely goes out of the area. minutes and change remaining before Kaya presumably wins the national championship. Here's another incursion. Handled well. Perez shoots it and makes it. Marco Perez, the substitute. This should be the icing on the cake for Kaya FC Iloilo. The substitute, Marco Lorenzo Perez, once he got a touch of that ball, it was as if he knew when to release. And that one evades Ponce de Leon and in. And the celebration, of course. One-on-one against Mandawi. Moves to his right. Had the opening and takes it. Just like that for Kaya FC Iloilo. It is now 5-0 for the men in black. As looks like it is safe to say, everything here is settled except the final score. But again, if you're Palawan, it's about playing to the level of Kaya, and also every possession, every sequence, you try to win the mini games within the game. As they say, dispossessed once again, Kaya unrelenting here, not satisfied with the scoreline yet. Palawan having some problems moving that ball to the middle. And now they do. They tried to go direct once again for Gabinete. It's retrieved by Dumaran. Good individual effort by Gabinete, but against two. Fortunately for him, foul was whistled by our top official, John Mike Basinang. Here's a long one. Kaya better be careful, but not a problem for Bata, who again wisely decides to go outside of the area. And that is Perez, the latest goal scorer for Kaya. 5 different goal scorers for the under-19 team of Kaya, just showing that depth that they have. Kaya FC Iloilo leaving this one for the left flank. Controlled, but the recovery from the defense. Good try again from Palawan to come up with a sequence. trying to target Kurt Venturillo. And now it goes back to Palawan. Could be a chance. Turn. But look at how quickly that defense established for Kaya. Five black shirts in the area. And not enough support for Palawan. Bagano. Diola back to Bagano. It stays onside. They go to the right flank. Gabinete. Well, Gabinete, you can really see that he's that skilled as Bata again collects. Just knows when to time it. Seventy-second minute here inside Rizal Memorial Football Stadium. That is in what has been, rather, a 5-0. A dominant match being played by Kaya right now. And another run. It's 2-4, however. Palawan takes care of business. Oh, but an errant pass. Could be an opening here for Kaya. Good challenge offered by Lester J. Mandawe. As they again try to connect, but Bata alert to whatever Palawan has in mind. Back and forth we go now. Perez. It's 3-5. Kaya, will they wait for numbers? It is won back by Tarin. We're trying to dance with his defender. Lost control for a moment. Guerrero is there to pick it up. It's still with Kaya. Couple of more substitutions about to enter for Kaya. Looks like we have Edgardo Lorenzo Irigo and Feliciano Fernandez. Player number 17 and player number 12. Magpapahinga na si Julian Romero. It's been a great afternoon for him just in terms of manning his area and surveying the field. Some playmaking from Romero. So Edgardo Lorenzo Irigo also in. It looks like Julian Paul Hanke also is one of the people responsible for really just setting up the countless incursions for Kaya inside the box. Also a well-deserved rest for him. As we continue to get closer to the final whistle, about 16 more minutes before Kaya is officially declared the national champion for the Under-19 Boys Division 2, the second division. Diola. Palawan sending it to the back, but not enough power on those passes. You have to be more crisp with those passes, especially against a tough Kaya side. It's just the little details here for Palawan that they have to master against an opponent of Kaya's caliber. They go inside the box. Well, not the proper English on that ball, causing it to not really spin much. It goes out, goal kick for Nathan Bata. As looks like he will preserve this clean sheet. It's 5-0 for Kaya at the moment. Dinge, who's now in the middle, used to really be of help manning that left wing. Oh, great individual effort from Fernandez. Just announcing his entry into the field. Now here's a lob inside. And now out of balance na doon. Yung forward ng Kaya. It's eventually picked up by Ponce de Leon. who had all the time in the world to collect that ball. Pineda, who's still part of the 11 on the field for Palawan, one of their key players. Change in direction here. They try to go inside the box. But Kaya's defense has once again established just a few seconds ahead. That pass took a deflection. Could have been offside if it went anyway. Napaganda pa for Kaya as a foul is blown. This is one of those matches where, yes, on paper, there have been many fouls. One yellow card so far, but it's not intensely physical in the sense that there have been skirmishes as that one takes a bounce and it's in. From long range once again, Kian Will Pampolina and the silencer celebration as well. Pulling off of LeBron is player number 78, Pampolina. Well, he just saw the opening and he decides to take it. And that one taking a lucky bounce from just under the crossbar. And it's goal number 6 for Kaya FC Iloilo. The onslaught continues here for Kaya after just 2 goals in the first half, 4 in the second. And again, it's just safe to say it is already settled, except the final score. Look at that. Once more. Lots of space. Oh, might as well take it. The mindset there exactly for Kian Will Pampolina. Palayo ng palayo, yung mga conversion ng Kaya rito. It's just testament to their quality, but also a challenge for Palawan to keep on playing with about 12 more minutes to go. The immediate challenge here for Palawan is to really just stop that bleeding, maybe even score one as Gabinete earns this corner kick for Palawan. Only the third corner set piece here for Palawan, and they intend to make the most out of it. It's 6-0 for Kaya, just total domination by the young men from Iloilo. Here's the lob, good elevation. It ends up with someone else, and finally cleared. Possessions have not been aplenty here for Palawan. And every time they have the ball, they obviously have a direct play, just giving it either to Pineda or Gabinete. But meanwhile, 5 substitutions here for Palawan. Elmo Fernandez, Jericho Libiran, Sander Abejero, Christian Tio. So mukhang lahat na ng substitutes ng Palawan na ipinasok na rito. One, during the halftime break, they have 6 outfielders dun sa kanilang substitutes. The only other substitute is the goalkeeper, si Winilito Makatangay Jr. We still have Zaki Ponce de Leon on the field, 80 minutes into this match. It's been that kind of an afternoon for them. Well, for Ponce de Leon, he's had his share of the spotlight. Some glorious saves, particularly towards the end of the first half. Kaya 2-0 lang yung abante ng Kaya from the first 45 minutes. However, the second half was a different story as Kaya FC Iloilo just continued to pour it on. Maya-maya po, once again, it's going to be Kaya FC Iloilo and their seniors squad going up against Davao Aguilas UMAC, as this could be goal number 7. It does not trickle in. Marco Lorenzo Perez disappointed. Could have been a brace for him. Let's see how the shot unfolded. Oh, it just bounces off the near post and out. As we were mentioning just moments earlier, again, Kaya FC Iloilo. Oh, deflected by Ponce de Leon. And the defense was there. No free goals for Ibrahim Tarin. Not at the moment, at the very least. Palawan not giving up on the play. And now a burst of energy here for Palawan. Flag stays down. And Guerrero concedes a corner for them. Great spell for Palawan FA. Ponce de Leon with the save. Looks like it was Mandawe with the effort. It's going to be a corner for Palawan. Ang bilis din ng transition from having to defend the play and then earning an opening for a counter-attack. Mababa on the delivery. And the ball contested. It goes to Palawan once again. They recycle the possession here. Libiran. Oh, but someone just getting in the way. But Ponce de Leon is there to collect. Just about 8 more minutes here before Kaya makes it official. But until that final whistle is blown, of course, they have to continue playing. Fernandez wins that ball for Kaya. 2 more substitutions to be made by Kaya FC Iloilo. Boris Malcolm Uy and Jaden Diris. ...83rd minute of the action. As Kaya FC Iloilo is pretty much on their way to winning this national title. The Vismin Group Stage Champions, the Group B winners, Kaya FC Iloilo, going up against the Luzon Group Stage Champions, Palawan, the Group A winner. But after the dust settles in just a few more minutes, it's going to be Kaya FC Iloilo crowned as the national champion of the U19 Boys National Championship 2nd Division here at the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium. Again, wag po silang aalis at 7 p.m. It's going to be Kaya FC Iloilo and their seniors men's squad going up against the Davao Aguilas University of Makati. And that is for all the marbles in the Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023. So do stick around. We'll have Claro Manzano and Ivan Gayares bringing you the action doon po sa ating kampyonato for the Copa 2023. Sino ba ang magwawagi ng ating year-ending domestic club football title? It's going to be Kaya versus Davao as this is another incursion for Kaya. Nail on the coffin and finally that brace is complete for Marco Lorenzo Perez as he proceeds to celebrate by removing one of his boots and making a call. Just another scramble inside the box for Kaya. And wala nang nagawa doon ang Palawan FA. Again, even if they marked the player, Marco Perez, well, the only player for Kaya with a brace at the moment. I think that is the side bet here for the players of Kaya. Sino ba yung unang makaka score ng brace rito? And it's Marco Lorenzo Perez, player number 23, the substitute for the U19 squad of Kaya FC Iloilo. 6 different goal scorers for Kaya. Just showing gaano kalalim yung kanilang koponan. 86 minutes have gone by. 4 more minutes and change to make it all official. It's been quite a dominant afternoon for Kaya FC-Iloilo. Palawan, they had their stretches where we felt they could have gotten away with something, but it's just all Kaya at the moment, defensively, offensively. Good 1-2 from Palawan. Fernandez. He get the ball inside the box. On the cutback, gathered by Bata. Difficult angle to create, really. And Bata does the rest. That was Pineda, of course. Jaril Pineda, one of the key players here. Good effort as well from Jaden Dries to just shadow him and make it difficult from his vantage point. Kaya taking their time, as has been the case since they went up 2-0 early on. It's lots of patience from Kaya FC-Iloilo. That ball left with lots of space for Perez. ...87th minute of this match. Perhaps it's also a good time to recap. So 9th minute of this match. Adrian Pesillier opening the scoring here for Kaya FC-Iloilo. 9 minutes into the match. And then 2 minutes after, Gail Guerrero with the second goal, as someone's booked here for Kaya. Unnecessary actions there for Jeffy Tinge, just kicking that ball out and delaying the play here, or the restart of the play. The foul was there. And then the reaction, that one, was what really merited that yellow. A delay in the restart of the play. So it was 2-0 after 11 minutes, and then 5 more goals for Kaya in the second half. Paunti-unti, they just built on that advantage, tong Kaya FC-Iloilo. 52nd minute, it was Jed Francisco from considerable distance as well, outside of the box. Then you had Benjamin Palacio, 63rd minute, an absolute screamer as well. And then, sunod-sunod na, you had Marco Perez in the 68th. Kian Pampolina, the longest conversion in the 77th. And then on the 85th, from close range, the solo effort from Marco Lorenzo Perez, once again completing a brace for him. And then making it 7-0 for Kaya FC-Iloilo. Last 2 minutes of regulation here, plus added time. As this ball is cleared, it's going to only delay the attack of Kaya. But as long as they keep that ball to their attacking half, you know that interesting things are about to happen. Tinge sends it back for now. Galsim, also credit to Kaya's back four. Just doing a terrific job of keeping everything handled well. Ayaw naman nilang machambahan rin dito ng Palawan. It's really how they play the game to a high level. Not just offensively, but all facets of it. So we have Gabriel Bautista, Gail Guerrero, Sian Galsim, then Julian Romero earlier. Patrolling that back four, that back line, pretty well for Kaya. Great effort on the part of Craig Livingston's players. And sabi rin ni Craig Livingston, there's the potential to be a good day for Kaya. And that is, of course, if they get the trophy for themselves. And then mamaya-maya, yung Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023 naman could be Kaya and Davao, of course, contesting for that title. Could be a sweep here for Kaya. As that one goes straight to the midst of Ponce de Leon. 3 more minutes of added time to make it all official for Kaya, as announced by our stadium announcer, David Umol. Chance here for Palawan. They get that ball into the box. See how they execute this. Pero bola mawawala as Jaden Dries gets in the way. 7-0 for Kaya FC Iloilo. It's only a matter of time before the final whistle is blown here by John Mike Basidang. What an effort here for Kaya. As looks like it's going to be a corner as well. That's the seventh corner for the men in black. Oh no, it's a set piece. Goal kick, rather. Last touch from one of the players of Kaya. Now again, if you're Palawan, it's important to put things in perspective. They managed to be the best team in Luzon. They had favorable results here, as someone has been decked. Favorable results against Cordillera FA, against Central Bicol, against Olongapo and Zambales. And Palawan, again. There's no other way to really put it, but it's the start of good things, of better things to come for the Football Association. And binabati natin lahat ng nanonood from Palawan, of course. Such a beautiful province with all the tourist destinations there. And it's good to know that there is a football grassroots program there that's good supply, you know, the future of Philippine football dito sa ating mga clubs, to the schools, the universities, and to our national team as well. As someone is suffering from cramps here, good show of sportsmanship from Kaya as well. Ilang minuto na lang bago ang pagtatapos ng larong ito. This is the championship of the PFF U19 Boys Second Division for 2023. This is the culminating match day of everything local football for the PFF. Of course, we still have Kaya, Stallion, and Cebu hosting home games next week as part of the international club football competitions. As far as local football is concerned, mamaya po, yun na ang pagtatapos. The culmination, it's Kaya FC Iloilo and Davao Aguilas UMAC for all the marbles. The Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023 title is at stake. And that match will kick off at 7 p.m. So don't go away. We'll have Claro Manzano and Ivan Gayares doing that game, delivering it to all of us, to all the viewers, to a much bigger platform. Nathan Bata finishing touches. And there you have it, the final whistle. Kaya FC Iloilo makes it official. They are the national champions of the PFF U19 Boys 2023 Second Division. Just sheer dominance from one of the most successful clubs and also one of the most successful grassroots programs. Kaya's Academy just showing what it can do in the youth level. Six different goal scorers for Kaya, led by a brace from the substitute Marco Lorenzo Perez. And we will have the awards, of course, later on. But again, after 90 minutes, after the dust has finally settled, of course, it's Kaya FC Iloilo. From the first 15 minutes or so, we felt it was going to be them, just in terms of how they controlled everything. And true enough, that's what they did. Let's just take a look at the recap of how this match unfolded. Again, first 9 minutes. And naka-score na po ang Kaya FC Iloilo. There's that sequence again. Francisco setting up Tingue. And then the finish by Adrian Pesilier. That was the opening goal, choosing the far post, of course, fittingly so. And from there, Kaya scored 6 more goals. Here's another look at that opening goal by Pesilier, which was the first of 6 more goals. They had 7 for the entire match. This was the corner kick that set up Gail Guerrero just 2 minutes after. So after 2 minutes, after Pesillier scored the opening goal, ito naman si Gail Guerrero, one of the tallest players on the field, taking advantage of that height and scoring goal number two for Kaya at the moment. 11 minutes into the field. Kaya would have more opportunities to score in the first half, but credit the effort of the goalkeeper, of the defense as well, of Palawan in that first half. They were competitive for most of it. Then this was the ball intended for Pineda, but Nathan Bata, although it wasn't a busy afternoon that much for him, just taking care of business when it had to be taken care of. And then, of course, to his credit, Zaki Ponce de Leon, the captain, the keeper for Palawan, also making sure that in the first 45 minutes, Palawan stayed competitive. A deflection here. Yeah, a couple of great saves in that first half. And then Pineda, not really that much intent or power to challenge Bata. Nevertheless, he committed. And then this was the sequence to really end that first half. Deflection. And then on the rebound, although you can see on the bottom of your screens, flag was up. Ponce de Leon. Well, from there, it was really Kaya FC-Iloilo just dominating. You have to give it all to Palawan, but the level was just there. Kaya FC-Iloilo, 79%. Of possession to them, 17 shots, of course, 7 on target. The 7 conversions that you saw. More corners from them, owing to the fact that they controlled that ball and had that ball mostly doon sa kanilang attacking half. And then the only blemish, perhaps, are the 2 yellow cards. You have to keep your emotions in check. We'll have Serge Caule of Davao, and we'll have Daiso Horikoshi of Kaya up next after this. But it looks like we're going to wrap up the coverage of the first game. And again, Kaya FC Iloilo 7 and Palawan FA 0. That is the final. Congratulations to Kaya FC Iloilo, the PFF U19 Boys National Champion for 2023 in the second division. And on behalf of the entire broadcast presentation crew here, as well as the football operations, looks like we are about to go to a break. And after this, we are going to crown Kaya FC Iloilo and their U19 team formally as the champions.
We have witnessed the potential, the future stars of Philippine football, and they have unleashed their performance as they're dubbed as the stars of tomorrow. We are set to award the champion of the PFF U19 Boys Second Division. But before we award the champion trophy, let's give a round of applause to the runner-up of the PFF U19 Boys Second Division National Championship, your Palawan FA! Let's give them a hand! All right. And let's proceed to the awarding of the trophy. May we call in the Philippine Football Federation Executive Committee Member for Luzon, Miss Lovely May Tababa, to award the national champions of your PFF U19 Boys Second Division, Kaya FC Iloilo.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The scenes on your screens right now, the official trophy presentation for Kaya FC Iloilo, the U19 Cowboys second division national champions. 7-0 for them. Total domination of Palawan FA, and that is the award that had been waiting for them this afternoon. What a sight to see as well, yung kanilang mga kuya from the Kaya FC-Iloilo men's senior squad, the reigning PFL champions, trying to go back-to-back this college career. And yun na, yung congratulate na rin yung kanilang mga nakababatang kakampi. All smiles, it's an ecstatic celebration for these players, for Coach Craig Livingston in the middle of his screens right now, the architect of this program. So once more, congratulations to Kaya FC-Iloilo, 7-0 shutout. Goals from Jen Francisco, Bill Guerrero, Vivian Basilier, Angelique Palacio, Will Pamplina, and of course the brace by the substitute Marco Lorenzo Perez, finishing touches on this dominant win against Palawan FA, who of course to their credit just gave it their all. This afternoon belongs to Kaya FC-Iloilo. They advance to Division 1, and so does Palawan FA. The biggest incentive of the fall belongs to Kaya FC-Iloilo. Will it be back-to-back for their men's senior squad? Makikita natin in just a short while, as it's going to be Kaya versus Davao UMAC for the Copa Paulino Alcantara 2023 championship, coming your way starting at about 6:45 in the afternoon, and then kickoff set at 7 p.m. So do stick around. We have lots more of football action here coming your way. There you have it, the national champions of the boys U19 of the PFF, Kaya FC-Iloilo and their U19 squad. So we wrap up our coverage here once again on behalf of our entire broadcast crew and our game day operations members here at the Rizal Memorial Football Stadium. We thank you all for joining us. This has been Levi Verona on the call, and as we always say, wherever you are, wherever you're from, we'll see you at the games.